Are you ready to get started on your first geography lab? Okay, here is a quick overview of the lab, plus some tips and tricks to the various web tools we will be using in this lab. To start out with, it's really important that you read over the entire lab handout so that you have a general idea of what you will be doing in this lab. In the first part of the lab, you will use your atlas. First, we will explore map scale and calculate distance using map scale. You find the map scale at the bottom of the page, here. One of the key skills we will be working on throughout the quarter is precision in measurement. Lab 1 skill video talks about this, and it will come into play on our first lab, so please make sure that you watch it. This lab will introduce you to one of the most commonly used coordinate systems, latitude and longitude. You will need your atlas for this part of the lab. Use the index, that is the part in the back of the atlas, to look up the various cities. Notice when you look up the latitude and longitude in the index of the atlas, it shows locations in degrees and minutes. For example, San Francisco is located at 37 degrees 45 minutes north and 122 degrees 26 minutes west. Another way to express latitude and longitude is in decimal degrees. A decimal degree is simply an expression of the minutes and seconds as a fraction of a degree. Let's see how this is done. 1 degree is 60 minutes. So for the latitude of San Francisco at 37 degrees 45 minutes, it's equal to 37 degrees and 45 sixtieths of a degree. A little bit of fantastic math, and reducing the fractions gives us 3/4, which in decimal form is 0.75. So we would express the latitude of San Francisco in decimal degrees as 37.75. Don't worry if you're not super fast at math. The lab provides you with an online converter. However, the one thing you really, really need to be on your toes about is that decimal degrees do not use letters. The reason is that computers use decimal degrees, and computers are kind of fussy and don't like to mix numbers and letters. So when we express latitude and longitude in decimal degrees, the northern hemisphere is a positive latitude, and the southern hemisphere is a negative latitude. The eastern hemisphere is a positive latitude, and the western hemisphere is a negative latitude. So the result of this is that San Francisco in decimal degrees would be 37.75 negative 122.43. The third part of the lab has you use Google Earth. I'm going to show you two things that sometimes trip people up: how to measure the distance with the ruler tool and how to load the sea surface temperature overlay. First, to use the ruler tool, let's open Google Earth. Okay, here we are in Google Earth. So to start out with, let's look at the measure tool. I'm going to go over and type in the Foothill College address, 12345 El Monte Road, Los Altos Hills, California, and zoom in. Woo! Always get a little dizzy watching that. And here we are at the Foothill College campus. So the lab asks you to measure the distance of the Foothill College campus from east to west. So that's basically the distance from the football stadium over here to the soccer fields and the baseball diamond over here. To use the measure tool, select the tool, looks kind of like a ruler, click on it, and you can select the units that you want to measure in: miles, kilometers, smoots, arc seconds, etc. We're going to use miles. And just click to start your measurement and click again to end your measurement. Next, let's move over to the sea surface temperature question in the lab. To load the sea surface temperature, let's go to the lab and click on the link. Here we are in Lab 1. Question 23 asks you to compare the ocean surface temperature off the east coast of the U.S. with the west coast of the U.S. So to do this, we want to open up the World and Regional Sea Surface Temperature link, which will open and load a KMZ file, which is an overlay in Google Earth. It should automatically load in Google Earth. If it does not, you can always navigate this file, the open with, to tell it to open with Google Earth. So I'm going to say OK. And here is Google Earth. My world and regional sea surface temperature is over here in my temporary places. I will turn it on. And just like that, we can see the ocean surface temperature. I can read the value of the ocean surface temperature using the legend down here at the bottom. It's very important when you are doing your lab write-up that you cite specific evidence such as temperature. So if you see something in the red, you can say that is over 80 degrees Fahrenheit. If you see something in this bright blue color, you can say that is around 50 degrees Fahrenheit, etc. Okay, that's about it for lab one. Make sure that you give yourself at least 3 to 4 hours to work on this lab. Start with enough lead time that you can post in the frequently asked questions if you get stuck. I'm here to help you. You are not taking this class alone. Happy trails!